Before the break, we talk about tonicity. We have three different kinds of tonicity. They can make the cells, depends on how the cells. The cells does not change the shape. That's called the isotonic. And when the cells shrink, that's the hypertonic. And if the cells swell, that's the hypotonic. So now let's look at how they make the cell swell or shrink. It's based on the water movement. And let's talk about experiment. This is the physiology experiment. You create a container, and you can put the artificial cell membrane. It becomes cheaper and cheaper. You can purchase it. You can separate them. They behave exactly like the cell membrane. It's semi-permeable, so some molecule can move through, others could not move through. And you separate them to two area. Then we add water. So we add water in one side. And you wait for a few minutes. What's going to happen? Well, we know water can move through the cell membrane. So water going to move through, and it becomes this. So two equal sides. So far, so good, right? So now let's add solute. Solute. We add penetrating particles. So you put six penetrating particles on one side. And you wait for a few minutes. And in the previous lecture, you learned every molecule want to go down the concentration gradient. So they will go from the high concentration area to the low concentration area. And the cell membrane is semi-permeable, but this is a penetrating particle. So this is going to move from here to here. The diffusion stops when there is no concentration gradient. That's what you learned last week. Okay, so two sides, equally amount of water, equally concentration. So far, so good. And now let's make the situation a little bit more interesting. Now let's add a non-penetrating particle. So we start to throw in non-penetrating particle. And we don't put 3, 3 because nothing going to happen. We put 2 and 4. So now what's going to happen? You have 2 non-penetrating here, 4 non-penetrating here. Ideally, this molecule want to move from here to here, right? I told you every molecule want to go down the concentration gradient from high to low. It naturally happen. The problem, cell membrane. As I keep telling you, cell membrane make your life difficult. Cell membrane is semi-permeable. If it's penetrating particle, yeah, it will move. But this guy is non-penetrating, so it won't be able to move. Even though you want to move from here to here, it could not. So what else can move? Water. It turns out the water going to move from here to make the concentration the same. And the result would be this. The result would be this. So it would be 2 non-penetrating, 4 non-penetrating because they could not move. So the water moved. The water volume would be 1 to 2. And you say the penetrating particle, well, they are penetrating particle. They will move until they are happy. So they will be balanced. And that's the result. That's the result. And water move, well, pretty familiar, right? Tonicity, we talk about tonicity. So my suggestion is, why I take the penetrating particle out? Because they won't make the water move. In the physiological, in the real situation, well, penetrating particle, they won't make the water move because they can move through the cell membrane. They will take care of themselves. What makes the water move is non-penetrating. That's very important in tonicity. So only the non-penetrating particle will make the water move, which means when we consider the tonicity, the solution makes the cell swell, shrink. That's the water move in, move out of the cell, try to dilute the non-penetrating particle. Only non-penetrating particle will decide tonicity, not penetrating particle. That's the take-home message for today. So I took the penetrating particle out because it won't affect the result. Water is going to move based on the non-penetrating particle. And after the non-penetrating particle decide the water, okay, because the non-penetrating particle, they are non-negotiable. And they will say, okay, it's done deal. I will put 2 to 4. Stop the discussion. And the water will say, okay, I will compromise. I'll move. Right? Water move 1 to 2. And after you figure out the water, well, penetrating particle, they will take care of themselves because they are penetrating. Every time they are not happy, they just move through the cell membrane. So they start from 3 and 3, they found, oh, water move, okay, I will move. to make it happy. So eventually, after you figure out the water, you add in the penetrating. And that's the strategy of solving the tonicity problem. You use the non-penetrating particle to decide the water move, because water move only based on the one they could not take care of themselves. So the non-penetrating particle decide the water movement, and then you figure out the penetrating particle. So that's the conclusion. Well, if you put the penetrating particle on two sides, they're going to move, put two, four, so this is prettier picture, and eventually they become the same. And you're going to reach the equilibrium. Equilibrium is the two sides, their concentration are the same, and volume 1:1. And when you put the non-penetrating particle, okay, well, this non-penetrating particle, you put two and four, they want to move from here to here. Every molecule want to go down the concentration gradient, but it could not, because this is the cell membrane. It blocked those non-penetrating particles. So what else can move? Water. Water can move. So water can move from here to here. It still move from low water to high water to low water, but I don't suggest students think that way. It confuses you. So I always say every particle move from high concentration to low concentration, but water move from low solute to high solute to dilute the solute. I found students easier. It's easier for them to take this concept. Water always go to the high concentration solute area, try to dilute the solute for the non-penetrating one. Once it reaches equilibrium, you found still the same concentration, even though the solid is 1 to 2, it's 2 to 4, it's 1 to 2 ratio, the volume is still 1 to 2 ratio. Eventually, there's no concentration gradient, still no concentration gradient, but not the particle move, it's the water move, and water movement, osmosis. So last time we talked about simple diffusion, and I told you the water diffusion, we never say water diffusion, we call it osmosis. Osmosis is water movement. Okay, so clinically, what's the non-penetrating particle? What's the penetrating particle? In this class, physiology, we keep it simple. So the non-penetrating particle, they're too big, like protein, and very important one, sodium chloride. And you say, well, in previous chapter, you learned the sodium channel, chloride channel, they're going to make the molecule move, yes. But most of them, they remain closed. Ion channel need to remain closed. If you want to open them, either use the chemically gated, mechanically gated, or ligand gated ion channel to open them. They remain closed. So, and artificial cell membrane, of course, there's no ion channel there. So the sodium chloride, non-penetrating. So if you put in on the ECF, they stay in the ECF. You put them in the ICF, they stay in the ICF. What's the penetrating particle? Small gas molecule, yes, it can move. But clinically, or in the physiology experiment, we use it a lot, urea. Urea, all you need to know in this class is small molecule and is penetrating. So it can free move through the cell membrane. And you found in the test, sometimes I will give you the total body water or I give you the heavy water, D2O. Heavy water means clinically they use the heavy water to identify the total body water volume. And I can give the ECF volume or I can give the inulin volume. Inulin is the molecule stay in the ECF. So you found sometimes I tell you, okay, the ECF volume, or sometimes I give you inulin volume, and that means the ECF volume. And Evan blue is the molecule to bind with the plasma protein. So Evan blue volume usually used to indicate the plasma volume. And you say, okay, during the test, I forgot. But remember, we're talking about the human. And we're not talking about what's the body water of the elephant. So we're talking about the human. If I give you the total, if I give you the heavy water volume is 42.3 liter, and the inulin volume is about 17 liters. So you do the math, you found it's about 1/3 of them. And you know this must be the ECF, and this must be the total body water. That's why we keep those numbers in mind. Like physiology man, about total body water is about 42 liter, and the ECF is about 16, and ICF is about 32. And in the ECF, about 1/4 of them, that's in the plasma. So plasma volume is about 3.5 liter. So if I give you the Evan Blue's volume, it's about 3, 3.2, 3.6, and you know, oh, I'm talking about the plasma volume. And the force to make the water move, that's the concentration gradient. So that's the concentration gradient of the solid and this non-penetrating particle. And water gonna move to dilute. And the water diffuse through the cell membrane. We don't call the water diffusion, we call it osmosis. So osmosis is water diffusion. Because water is so important in the physiology, so we call it osmosis. And the pressure to make the water move, once you create the concentration gradient, the water gonna move, and that pressure is osmotic pressure. So if you have more solute in one side than the other, non-penetrating solute, and they're gonna attract more water to move, well, osmotic pressure is higher. That's how they define osmotic pressure. Okay, let's go back to this. We did the calculation, right? So now we know tonicity is very important. And clinically, we want to put the solution into the human's body. We want to use the isotonic. Why this is so important clinically? They use this to dilute all the IV solution, because normal saline, 0.9%, 0.9% saline, normal saline, this is the isotonic solution. So calculate osmolarity, we did the calculation, number of particles. That's why physiology, we use osmolarity, we don't use molarity, because it's closer to the real situation. In your body, you have a lot of water, so we consider how many particles they have per volume. We use osmol, we use milliosmol. And your body have a range. It's not exactly that number. Clinically, if your osmolarity is in this range, about 280, 300, or we take a solution, we do the calculation, we found osmolarity is around this range, we consider this isotonic. Because that your cell gonna behave normally in that solution. So tonicity, we care about this red blood cell. Your body have a lot of red blood cell. And when you put the solution into the body, well, if the cells is not happy, the water have free pass through the cell membrane, can flow in, which gonna make the cell swell, or flow out, which make the cell shrink. And that's tonicity. So possibility, we only have three. That's why the tonicity, we have so many different kind of concentration of solution, but when we talk about tonicity, we only have three: hypertonic, isotonic, and hypotonic. So we have three different kind of solution. Isotonic solution will make the cell happy, right? Nothing change. And that's why we like red blood cell, because it has donut shape. And we'll talk more about it in the respiratory system. Why respiratory system. We'll talk about the blood, because it carries the oxygen to your tissue. And why it has donut shape, it's easier for them to squeeze through the small capillary. So they take the nucleus out. Red blood cell does not have nucleus. So if it remains the same shape, it's still a donut. And if the water flow in, make the cell swell, that's hypotonic. And example, pure water. So when you put pure water, well, water gonna move in, try to dilute the cell, and the cell gonna swell. Or you use the big word called hemolyze. Hemolyze means the cell swell or burst. So if you drink too much water, it's actually bad. Well, and most people don't know that. Most people know if you don't drink water, that's not good. But they don't know everything in your body. So you gradually build the concept. Everything in your body need to be in the normal situation. So if you drink too much good stuff, drink too much water, it can be toxic. And if you put the hypertonic solution, the cell gonna shrink, because water flow out to dilute the salt. Example, salt. So 100 years ago, people keep the food, right? They put the meat covered with salt. That's a super hypertonic situation. And the reason is all the water flow out, try to dilute the salt. And no water, no bacteria can survive. So the meat can be kept for months or sometimes years. And this is a super hypertonic situation. So we have three tonicity. Okay, let's take a short break.